Princeton University delaying its return from winter break due to the COVID surge. Once students do come back, they will not be allowed to leave the county. Yes, I said the county. Can't leave the county till mid-February. Myles McKnight is a student at Princeton. He's a correspondent for Campus Reform, and he joins me now. Myles, let me try and get this straight. You are required to be vaccinated. You're being told to stay in your rooms as much as possible. You've got a mask up, and you can't leave the county until mid-February. I think I got that right. Now you tell me why Princeton is doing this.
Well, good morning, Stuart. So the university instated some of these regulations in light of surging COVID cases in New York and New Jersey. And some of the regulations are perfectly reasonable, like testing requirements. Others sort of fit within this broader trend that Campus Reform has reported on at universities across the country, which is inconsistency and illogicality with some of the policies. So just to give you an example, with the travel restriction, we're not able now to leave the immediate county surrounding Princeton. But if a university sports team or a university-sponsored club wants to travel across the entire country to play a game or whatever, that's perfectly fine. Or another inconsistency, you know, we're not allowed to gather in groups of over 20 without, you know, we have to wear masks and there's no food allowed, but the university is allowing, you know, students to gather in the hundreds unmasked in dining halls. So there's inconsistency here, and I can't really explain it.
If I was a student at Princeton, I'd be really unhappy about this, because my university life is being destroyed. The experience of university is being taken away from me. How do the other students feel?
I think students are frustrated and concerned. A lot of these changes are reminiscent of where we were last spring with virtual learning. Yeah. And with that, you know, the university saw a record mental health crisis, record numbers of mental health hospitalizations, counseling appointments, and a number of regulations that came with a harsh disciplinary scheme. So the university caused students to be really stressed because they hired private investigators to hound students for even trivial COVID violations. Students were encouraged to snitch on each other. Students made phony allegations about large friend groups to get back at them for petty drama. And I know of one instance in which a student was sexually assaulted. That was reported to the university. And instead of doing anything real about the sexual assault allegation, the university dished out harsh consequences to the alleged victim and her friends. So it's frustrating and worrisome.
Well, look, thanks very much for coming on the show and telling us all about it, because I never imagined it was as bad as that. Come back and see us again soon, see how these restrictions are going down. Thanks very much, Myles. We'll see you soon.